Hello everyone, welcome to Blue Cube channel. As you probably know, light layers in After Effects cause light to radiate to other layers. You can use four types of light sources for lighting. In this video you will learn the following topics. How to add various light sources to the project. How to adjust light sources. Making animation using light sources. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I recommend that you subscribe so that you can see the next tutorials. To create a light source, we must first have a 3D layer in the timeline. In the previous lesson, you completely learned how to create a 3D layer, so if you haven't seen that tutorial, I recommend that you definitely see it. By pressing the 3D button, I will convert this layer into a 3D layer. Now I right-click in this empty space and click on light from the new menu. In this window, we can set the type of light source and light settings. In the name section, we can type another name for the light layer. Also, in the light type section, we can choose the desired light source. For now, I choose the spotlight source, which actually works like a spotlight. They are usually more focused circular lights that you can control how wide or narrow it is. Before I explain the settings of this light source, I click on the OK button to create the light source. In this way, I created a light source, but as you can see, the light does not work. To solve this problem, I open the text layer and set the ambient value to 0 in the material options section, so that the text layer receives light only from the light source. Note that when we set ambient light to 0, the main color of the text has no effect on the text anymore, and now we can only see the color of the light on the text. We can also adjust the ambient value. I set its value to 0 and close the material option. Now, to go back to the light source settings, I double-click on the light layer. Here I choose the color of the light. You can choose any color. Using the intensity option, we adjust the intensity of the light. I think 400 is appropriate here. The cone angle option sets the width of the light beam or the cone around the light source. Next is cone feather, which determines the amount of softness of the spotlight edge. Note that the cone angle and cone feather options are active if the spotlight source is selected. The falloff option specifies the amount of light reduction along the distance. Now, by selecting none in the falloff menu, if we increase the distance between the layer and the light, the brightness will not decrease. The smooth option shows a gradual decrease in light. We can also set the radius and falloff distance, which determines the distance of the gradual decrease of the light. Inverse square clamped is a different type of light drop that replicates the behavior of light in the real world. It causes the light to be very bright at the point closest to its source and dims very quickly as it moves away. For now, I choose none. If I activate the Cast Shadows button, it creates a shadow, otherwise it does not create a shadow. We usually activate it. The option Shadow Darkness determines the amount of shadow darkness and Shadow Diffusion determines the amount of softness of the shadow. Finally, I press the OK button to create the light. As I explained in the previous lesson about 3D layers, after adding light, we can move the light source in the X, Y, and Z axis. In After Effects, like most software, the X axis is shown in red, the Y axis is shown in green, and the Z axis is shown in blue. Now I'll move the light source a little to the left and hold down the Shift button to make the light source move in a straight line. By moving this point, we can rotate the light barrier and set it on the desired layer. We can also move the light source in X, Y, and Z axis. One of the tools for rotating the light source is the rotation tool, which we use by holding the left click and moving the mouse on the axis. By opening each light layer and in the light options section, there are exactly the same light settings that I explained at the beginning of this tutorial. From here you can also change the light settings. I close this layer and click on it. Now I press Ctrl plus D keys to make a copy of this light source. In this way, Spotlight 2 is created. Now I press the letter P to reveal the position for the new light. Now, by changing the X value, I move the light source to the right. And I move this point to adjust the direction of the light. In this way, the middle of the text becomes brighter than the corners. Right-click again in this empty space and create a new light. I select the point light source and select yellow as the light color. The point light works like a lamp and illuminates the surroundings. The closer the layers are to this light, the brighter they become. The same settings that I explained for spotlight are also available for point light, with the difference that some settings for point light are disabled. I click on the OK button to create the point light. Now I'm going to place this yellow light source above the text. So I move it up on the Y-axis and back on the Z-axis. In order to be able to place the light exactly above the text, I choose two views. In this way, I can see the text both from the top view and from the front view. You can see that the name of each view is written in the left corner. Every view that you click on becomes active. Now I zoom a little in the top view and place the point light source above the text. I raise the light source slightly from the front view. In this way, the yellow light shines from above to the text. I open the light point layer and increase the light intensity. I think the value of 450 is suitable. Now I close the layers and go back to the main view. I will right-click again in this empty space, and this time I will select parallel light source. Parallel light is like sunlight and emits a lot of light from a distant source. Again, the same settings that I explained for spotlight are also available for parallel light, with the difference that some settings for parallel light are inactive. I click on the OK button, and this is how the light is created. I move the parallel light source to the corner of the text, and double-click on its layer and select blue color for this light. In this way, we can see that a beautiful color combination is created. I press the space button to better see the effect of light rays on the text. Now I turn off all the lights and right-click in this empty space, and this time I select ambient light source. Ambient light will create lighting for your entire scene, but the light source is not created in the scene. I set the light color to green and click on the OK button. We can see that the ambient layer is created, but there is no light in the composition panel. In order for ambient light to work, I set the renderer to classic 3D. I also open the text layer and increase the ambient value in the material options section. In this way, the ambient green light shines on the text, which we can adjust its value. If we double-click on the ambient layer, we can change the color of the light. Now let's create an animation with light sources. So I turn off the ambient light and turn on the other lights. And again I choose Cinema 4D as renderer. I click on the spotlight layer and press the R key to activate the rotation. I set the time indicator to the 5th second and create a keyframe for the Y rotation. I place the time indicator at frame 0 and change the Y rotation value to rotate the light source to the left. In this way, the light source gradually shines on the text. Now I click on the Spotlight 2 layer and press R to activate the rotation. I put the time indicator at 5 seconds and create a keyframe. I place the time indicator at frame 0 and change the Y rotation value so that the light source rotates to the right. I do not create any keyframes for the point light layer. Now I open the parallel light layer and enter the light options section. I place the time indicator at the 6th second and create a keyframe for intensity. I set the time indicator to 4 seconds and set the intensity percentage to 0 so that the intensity of the light gradually increases. Now I close all the layers, place the time indicator at the 6th second, and press the N key to shorten the work area. Finally, I press the space button to play the animation of the lights. This is everything you need to know about light sources in After Effects. Well guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. See you next time.